हेलो फ्रेंड, दिस इज़ जुबैर खान एंड यू आर वॉचिंग जोरावी नर्सिंग ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। वंस अगेन आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक, मैनेजमेंट ऑफ डिसअरेथमियाज। सो इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन द डिसअरेथमियाज। व्हाट आर द डिसअरेथमियाज? इज देयर एट्रियल फिब्रिलेशन, वेंट्रिकुलर फिब्रिलेशन, वेंट्रिकुलर टैकीकार्डिया, एट्रियल फ्रेटर। This everything we have seen. Now we will see the management of these arrhythmias, how we can manage these arrhythmias. So this thing we will see. So first is vagal maneuvers. First is vagal maneuvers. In vagal maneuvers, what we can do? So in vagal maneuvers, we have to do the vagal stimulation. Vagal stimulation means we need to stimulate the vagus nerve. How we can do that? So and what will be happen for this? So vagal maneuvers induce vagal stimulation of the cardiac condition system and are used to terminate the supraventricular tachyarrhythmias. So we know if vagal stimulation is there, it will cause to the decrease in the heart rate. So whenever we do vagal stimulation, so it will terminate the supraventricular tachy dysrhythmias. Whatever tachy dysrhythmias is there, tachycardia, ventricular tachycardia and supraventricular tachycardia, these all will be terminated and heart rate will come down. So for that we are doing vagal stimulation. Okay, number two is carotid sinus massage. So carotid sinus massage also we can do. So how we will do carotid sinus massage? The SCP instruct the client to turn the head away from the side to be massaged. So SCP will instruct the client to turn the head. Okay, so at that he will turn the head and one side over one carotid artery we can massage it for few seconds to determine whether a changes in cardiac rhythm occurs or not. So SCP massage over one carotid artery for few seconds, then he will monitor the cardiac rhythm. The client must be on cardiac monitor. So it is very important point here. Whenever any cardiac things we are going to do, he should be always in cardiac monitor. Okay, whether it is any therapeutic measurement and diagnostic, and so we are going to do here these things. So we need to monitor the cardiac things. Okay, so what we need to do in electrocardiography is before and during and after procedure should be documented on the chart. So before the procedure, during the procedure and after the procedure, these three things we need to monitor and we need to write on the chart. Then have a defibrillator and resuscitative equipments, because we are going to do vagal stimulation or any carotid massage. If any emergency occurs, so we should have keep ready with the defibrillator and resuscitative equipment. Okay, so we need to monitor the vitals, cardiac rhythms and level of consciousness also following the procedure. So these are the things. Vital signs is very important. Cardiac rhythm is very important, whether it is rhythmic or non-rhythmic, or level of consciousness, whether the client is conscious or not. These things we need to monitor. Now third point is Valsalva maneuver. So this everything you know, I think, Valsalva maneuver. So in Valsalva maneuver, what we can do? How it will manage the cardiac dysrhythmia? So SCP instruct the client to wear down and induce a gag reflex. So he will induce the gag reflex in the client to stimulate the vagal response. So gag reflex will induce the vagal response. Okay, so it will stimulate the vagus nerve. So how? Monitor the heart rate. What we need to do in that? Monitor the heart rate, rhythm and VP that time. Observe the cardiac monitor for change in rhythm. Record an electrocardiac ECG step before, during and after procedure also we need to do. Provide an MSS basin. Okay, we are going to stimulate the gag reflex. So we are going to stimulate the gag reflex. Okay, so if gag reflex occurs, patient may have a MSS, vomiting he may have. So provide a basin. So we need to provide the basin to for vomit or kidney tray. Okay, K basin we can provide. Initiate the precautions to prevent aspiration. Okay, so we need to initiate the precautions to prevent aspiration. So we need to keep the client in a sideline position and all. ओके सो पेशेंट शुड नॉट एस्पिरेट दैट कंटेंट. सो वी नीड टू कीप एन इन माइंड बिकॉज इफ पेशेंट इज हैविंग वॉमिटिंग ही मे हैव अ रिस्क फॉर एस्पिरेशन. सो वी नीड टू प्रोवाइड सम पोजिशंस लाइक साइड लाइन पोजिशन टू प्रिवेंट द एस्पिरेशंस. ओके हैव अ डिफिब्रिलेटर रिससेटिव इक्विपमेंट्स अवेलेबल. सो वी शुड कीप द डिफिब्रिलेटर फॉर दिस ऑल्सो एंड रिससेटिव इक्विपमेंट्स. ओके कार्डियोवर्धन. सो दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, इम्पॉर्टेंट प्रोसीजर कार्डियोवर्धन. सो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोसीजर कार्डियोवर्धन एंड डिफिब्रिलेशन. सो फर्स्ट वील सी द कार्डियोवर्धन. वॉट इज कार्डियोवर्धन? कार्डियोवर्धन इज द सिंक्रोनाइज्ड काउंटर शॉक. सो सिंक्रोनाइज्ड कार्डियोवर्धन एंड डिफिब्रिलेटर इन बोथ कंडीशन इन बोथ प्रोसीजर वी प्रोवाइड द शॉक. ओके सो बट इन कार्डियोवर्धन इट इज अ सिंक्रोनाइज्ड शॉक. इट इज अ सिंक्रोनाइज्ड शॉक. सो वी प्रोवाइड इन दिस सिंक्रोनाइज्ड शॉक टू कन्वर्ट अ अनडिजायरेबल रिदम टू स्टेबल रिदम. ओके अनडिजायरेबल रिदम टू स्टेबल रिदम. कार्डियोवर्धन कैन बी एन इलेक्टिव प्रोसीजर परफॉर्म्ड बाय एससीपी फॉर स्टेबल टैकीरिथमियाज रेजिस्टेंस टू मेडिकल थेरेपीज और इमरजेंट प्रोसीजर फॉर हीमोडायनामिकली अनस्टेबल वेंटिकुलर एंड सुपरा वेंटिकुलर डिसरिथमियाज. सो दिस कार्डियोवर्धन फॉर होम वी कैन डू लाइक एनी एट्रियल फिब्रिलेशन इज देयर. वेंटिकुलर टैकीकार्डिया इज वेंटिकुलर टैकीकार्डिया मीन्स पल्स इज देयर विद पल्स वेंटिकुलर टैकीकार्डिया इज देयर एंड इफ पेशेंट इज हीमोडायनामिकली अनस्टेबल एंड वेंटिकुलर एंड सुपरा वेंटिकुलर टैकीरिथमियाज इज देयर फॉर दैट पेशेंट वी कैन गिव द कार्डियोवर्धन. इन दिस कंडीशन पेशेंट विल बी कॉन्शियस व्हेन वी आर गिविंग द कार्डियोवर्धन. ओके कार्डियोवर्धन फॉर कार्डियोवर्धन पेशेंट विल बी ऑन कॉन्शियस कंडीशन. सो फॉर दैट वी नीड वी यूज द कार्डियोवर्धन. ओके अ लोअर अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी इज यूज देन विद डिफिब्रिलेशन. सो इन डिफिब्रिलेशन हाई अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी वी यूज वेयर इज इन कार्डियोवर्धन देयर विल बी अ लो अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी. द डिफिब्रिलेशन इज डिफिब्रिलेटर इज सिंक्रोनाइज टू द क्लाइंट आर वेव टू अवॉइड डिस्चार्जिंग द शॉक ड्यूरिंग द वल्नरेबल पीरियड टी वेव. इफ वी आर गोइंग द गिव द शॉक by defibrillator. So defibrillator is a asynchronized shock. Okay, if it is we are giving by that also, so it should be synchronized. Always we are giving, so it should be synchronized. On what? When we have to give? On the R wave. Okay, like P, Q or R. So for this R wave only we need to give. That's why we are giving, that is synchronized. Synchronized means we are going to put at that particular time. Okay. Particular time means it will be automatically when R wave will occur, that shock counter shock will be administered at that time. So it will monitor that cardiovascular will monitor the heart rate or and ECG rhythm, and that when R wave is occur, that time itself it will deliver the shock. Okay, by itself it will continuously monitoring when it has to deliver. Whereas in defibrillator it will be in asynchronized shock. Okay, so avoid the discharging the shock during the vulnerable period. Okay, so when T wave is occurring, that time we should not provide the shock. Okay, so in this condition when we are giving by the cardioversion, so cardioversion is always put on the R wave. When R wave is occurring, that time only we need to put the shock. It will automatically put on the when R wave is occurring. Okay, if T wave it is giving on the T wave, when T wave is occurring, that is vulnerable. If it is given at that time, it will lead to the VT and VF. So it has written like this only. If defibrillator is not synchronized, it is not synchronized, it could discharge on the T wave. When it is not synchronized, it will discharge on the T wave. When T wave is occurring, then shock will be given. It may given on the T wave. When it is given on the T wave, then it will lead to the ventricular fibrillation. So whenever we are giving by defibrillation also, and it is not the condition of ventricular fibrillation, at that time we should give on the R wave. It should be delivered by on the R wave if we are giving by defibrillator also. So by defibrillator also, it should be given in the synchronized form. If it is given in the synchronized form, so it should be given on the R wave also. Whether if it is not synchronized, it may deliver the discharge on the T wave, then what will cause? It will cause to the life threatening condition, that is ventricular fibrillation. So always keep in mind, it should be on synchronized. Okay, when ventricular fibrillation is not there, only ventricular tachycardia is there and pulse is present and patient is conscious. So in that condition, only cardioversion is used. In cardioversion also, it should be synchronized. And when it has to given on R wave, when R wave is occurring, that time itself this shock should be delivered. Okay, if this is not synchronized, it is the main important point. This is, if it is not synchronized, it may deliver the shock on the T wave. If it is delivered on the T wave, then ventricular fibrillation will occur. Okay, so ventricular why? Because it is synchronized, the R wave will be like this. So ventricular tachycardia will be like this. Okay, so ventricular tachycardia is there, so this condition we need to put the shock, so it will make a proper ECG. If we are giving on the T wave, so it will again lead to the, it will not form the T wave and will not form the normal ECG. Again it will lead to the like this dysarrhythmia, that means ventricular fibrillation it will cause. So proper ECG will not come if it is delivered on the T wave. Okay, so pre-procedure intervention, what we have to do? So in pre-procedure interventions, so here first thing, it is an elective procedure. Okay, so for that we need to get the consent form. Okay, it is an elective procedure, so we need to get the consent form. Administer sedation as prescribed. So what we do in cardioversion is not a sudden doing procedure. Cardioversion will be pre-planned. It will be pre-planned cardioversion, whereas defibrillator is emergency situation. In that emergency situation, we need to do the defibrillation. Okay, so in this condition, what we do? So we need to get the informed consent. Okay, for cardioversion we need informed consent. Administer sedation, so patient should be sedated. Okay, an elective procedure, if an elective procedure, hold digoxin for 48 hours before the pre-procedure is prescribed to prevent the post-cardioversion ventricular irritability. So we need to withhold the digoxin how much hours before? 48 hours before the cardioversion. So digoxin should be withheld. And if in an elective procedure for atrial fibrillation or atrial flutter, the client should receive anticoagulant therapy. If we are giving for atrial fibrillation or atrial fibrillation, patient should be given to the, and patient will be on anticoagulant therapy. So should receive the anticoagulant therapy. Why? We know if atrial fibrillation is there, so atrium will be having so much vibration, so zero contraction, less contraction will be there, so ventricular filling will be less. Yesterday itself told, in previous class I told, ventricular filling will be very less. So ventricular filling will be less, so blood will be collected into atrium, so blood clotting formation will be there. So blood, for that blood coagulation we need anticoagulant therapy. So patient should get the anticoagulation therapy for 4 to 6 weeks pre-procedure. Okay, so we are going to give this cardioversion, so before that 4 to 6 weeks patient should get the anticoagulation therapy. Why? Because if we are giving this counter shock also, again it is a risk for coagulation in the atrium. And transesophageal echocardiogram, so we need to perform the transesophageal echocardium should be performed to rule out the clots in the atria prior to the procedure. So before the procedure, we need to assess the whether any clots is there in atria or not. So what, for that we need a procedure, that is TEE, transesophageal echocardiogram. So these are the things we need to keep in mind. Now during the procedure, what we have to do? So we are giving the counter shock, we are giving through a cardioversion. So for that we are going to put a pads on the skin. So we need to ensure the skin is clean, dry, and where the electrodes, pads, hands off will be placed. Okay, it should be clean and dry. स्टॉप द ऑक्सीजन ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसीजर टू अवॉइड द हैजर्ड्स ऑफ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दिस वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दिस व्हाट वेन एवर वी आर गिविंग वेदर इट इज डिफिब्रिलेशन और वेदर इट इज डिफिब्रिलेटर और कार्डियोवर्जन वी नीड टू स्टॉप द ऑक्सीजन बिकॉज ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसीजर इट इज द हैजर्ड्स ऑफ फायर अवॉइड टू हैजर्ड्स ऑफ फायर सो वी नीड टू स्टॉप द ऑक्सीजन ओके वी नीड टू रिमूव द मास्क एंड ऑल ऑक्सीजन मास्क एंड ऑल ओके सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इन दिस नाउ कमिंग टू नेक्स्ट पॉइंट बी श्योर दैट नो वन इज टचिंग बेड सो दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिफोर एडमिनिस्ट्रिंग और बिफोर गिविंग द शॉक वी श्योर वी शुड मॉनिटर वी शुड सी द No one should touch the bed or client when delivering the counter shock and check the entire length of the client 3 times. This is also important. It can come in the questions. So these in Saunders, each line is very important. So each line comes means each line is question only. Question or your options of questions. So they can give this line in options. So they can ask which one is wrong, which one is right. Okay. So these lines will be there, but we don't see properly. So that's why we left the question or we wrong the question. So it is very important. So check the client's entire length of clients. How many times? 3 times. So they can give the 4 times. Check the client 4 times, 2 times, 1 time. So we should check the client entire length 3 times. And no one should touch the bed or patient. And oxygen should be removed. Oxygen should add. During the procedure, oxygen mask and all should be removed. Now coming to post-procedure intervention. So post-procedure, what we need to do? So priority assessment include ability of the client to maintain the airway and breathing. So first we need to maintain the airway and breathing. Always ABCs comes first and resume the oxygen administration as prescribed. So first we need to maintain the patency of airway and breathing. Then we need to administer the oxygen, then vital signs, then assess the level of consciousness, monitor the cardiac rhythm, whether cardiac rhythm is okay or not, any problem is there. Monitor for indication successful response, such as conversion of sinus rhythm, whether it is the rhythm is converted in the sinus rhythm, strong peripheral pulses is there, BP is adequate or not, and urine output is adequate or not. So these things we need to monitor. Assess the skin of the chest. Okay. Assess the skin on the chest. How? Assess the skin on the chest for evidence of any burns and edges of pads is there or not. So we are going to give a shock. We have given shock. So patient's skin may burn. So we need to monitor for this. So this is the cardioversion. And cardioversion same. Defibrillation only, but some difference are there when we need to give the defibrillation and all. So that is the main things here we need to watch it. So defibrillation is a asynchronized counter shock. That was the synchronized. It will be a asynchronized used to terminate the ventricular pulseless ventricular tachycardia and ventricular fibrillation. So when pulseless VT is there, pulseless VT and VF. These two condition only we use defibrillation. In this condition patient will be what? Unconscious. So patient will be unconscious. So in this condition when patient is unconscious and emergency condition is there, pulseless VT is there or VF is there, we need to give the defibrillation. So defibrillation we are going to give. So for that we no need to any concern. For cardioversion only we need any concern form. And defibrillator is charged one, so there will be two phase. One is biphasic, one is no monophasic. If you are giving by biphasic, so charge should be delivered 120 to 200 joules. Maximum is 200 joules. If it is given by monophasic, so it should be 360 joules for one counter shock from the defibrillator. And then CPR should be resumed immediately and continued for 5 cycles about to 2 minutes. So if patient is having VT or VF, so first itself we need to start the CPR. Okay, then we need to, and meanwhile another nurse will charge the defibrillation, then we have to give the counter shock. If in question, in previous class also I told, if question is there, so what is your first response? In first response, if CPR is there in option, so first we need to choose the CPR, then next option will come defibrillation. So this question comes always. Okay, reassess the rhythm after 2 minutes, and if VF or pulseless VT continues, the defibrillator is charged to give a second shock. If VF and VT is continue, pulseless VT is there, again it's there, so again we need to give the second shock of the defibrillation. The same energy level previously, whatever we have used. So we have used like 360, so same 360 again we need to give. Okay, if you are using 200, so same 200 you need to give in second shock. You need no need to decrease the energy. Okay, before defibrillating a client and after that, resume the CPR after shock and continue with the life support protocols. So after giving the shock also we need to resume the CPR. Before defibrillating a client, be sure that oxygen is shut off to avoid the hazards of fire, and be sure that the no one is touching the bed or client. So this is very important precaution is there. So we need to see what oxygen should be shut off, and we need to see no one is touching the bed or client. So that is very important. So that is our nurse's responsibility. Use of paired electrodes. So how we can use the paired electrodes? So one pair is placed at the third intercostal. So one pair will be placed on the third intercostal space, where right to the sternum. So this is your sternum, and this is your right side, this is your left side. So it should be placed here, third intercostal. Okay, so this is right side of the sternum, and other should be on fifth intercostal here. So one should be given here and one should be given here. And apply femp pressure at least 25, femp pressure means 25 pound. So 25 pounds will be, we should deliver the what pressure. Okay, so this much we have to administer. Be sure no one is touching the, again that same point comes for this also. Pads for hands off biphasic defibrillation may be applied in an anterior posterior positions, and apex posterior position and placement directly over the breast tissue should be avoided. So whenever we are giving the biphasic defibrillator, may be applied on the anterior posterior position. So it can be given the anterior posterior position or apex posterior positions, and placed directly over the breast tissue should be avoided. So it should not be kept on the breast tissues. So on the, like this is breast, so on the breast you should not give. So it, you can keep here down the, below the breast. Okay, so it should be avoided. Okay, now coming to automated external defibrillator, so AED. So how we use this? So an AED used by lay persons and emergency medical technician for pre-hospital cardiac arrest. So before the patient reached to the hospital, so it should be used automated external defibrillator. So place the client on femp and dry surface and stop CPR. Ensure that no one is touching the client to the avoid motion artifact during the rhythm analysis. Place the electrode patches at the correct position on the client's chest. So in this, there is no need of any medical technicians. So emergency medical technicians, it is used by lay persons and emergency medical technicians, no specific SCP and all. So while lay person also it can be used. Okay, in that we will place the electrode patches on the correct position on the client chest, and what will happen, we have to press the analyzer button to identify the rhythm. So first we need to press the analyzer button to identify the rhythm, whether rhythm is shockable or not, what is that. So which makes 30 seconds, it will take to 30 seconds, the machine will advise whether shock is necessary or not. So this will tell you within 30 seconds. So it will take to 30 seconds. The shocks are recommended for pulseless VT and VF only. Usually 3 shocks are delivered. Okay. So shocks will be delivered, recommended for if VT is there, pulseless VT is there and VF is there. So it should be delivered only 3 shocks. So it should be delivered only 3 shocks by AED also. So that is very important. If it is unsuccessful, we need to continue the CPR for 1 minute. So 1 minute CPR should be continued, then another series of shocks delivered. Like we give the this defibrillation, same only this AED automated defibrillation will be done. Now another important automated implantable. Okay, that was the automated external defibrillator. This is implantable cardioverter defibrillator, AICD. So what we do in this, AICD monitor the cardiac rhythm and detects, terminates the episodes of VT and VF by delivering the 25 to 30 joules up to 4 times. So it will be delivered 25 to 30 joules only energy and up to 4 times if necessary. So up to 4 times we can give if necessary. AICD is used in the clients with episodes of spontaneous sustained VT. If it is spontaneous sustained VT and VF unrelated to MI. So if the VT and VF is not related with MI, then we can use the AICD. And in clients whose medication therapy has been unsuccessful, or whether this arrhythmic medication is unsuccessful, we can go with the AICD to controlling the life-threatening dysarrhythmias. Then transverse electrode leads are placed in the right atrium. That electrode leads will be placed in the right atrium and ventricle in contact with the endocardium. So it will be placed in the right atrium and ventricles with the endocardium. So endocardium is there in that attachment with the endocardium on the right side of the heart. And leads are used for sensing, pacing and delivering the cardioversion or defibrillation. So it will first assess, then it will deliver the shock. The generator most commonly implanted in the left pectoral region. So where it will be implanted, like this is your right side, this is your left side, this is sternum. So this is your pectoral girdle. So here it will be implanted, that is left side. So left side of the body, it will be left pectoral region, it should be implanted. So client education, what we need to teach the client. So instruct the client basic function of AICD. So we need to tell the client how it work, how, what is the main energy level and all. So what you need to do, this everything we need to tell the client. Know the rate cut off the AICD and the number of consecutive shocks that it will be deliver. Wear the loose fitting, this is important very. So he should wear the loose fitting clothes over the AICD generator sides. Instruct the client on activities to avoid, including contact sports to prevent trauma to the AICD and lead wire. So he should avoid the like activities, sports and running and all, so which can lead to the trauma. So it will be affect on the AICD. So like this type of activity should be avoided. Report any fever. This is also very important here, one line. Any fever, redness, swelling and drainage from the incisor side is there, should be informed to the SCP. Report symptoms of fainting. Fainting is there, nausea, weakness, blackouts, rapid pulse is there. Then again, he should report the SCP. During shock discharge, the client may feel faint and shortness of breath. So we should inform the patient before itself. Yeah, during the shock, patient may have a fainting or shortness of breath can be there. Instruct the client to sit or lie down if he or she feels a shock and notify the SCP. So whenever he is feeling the shock, he should sit or lie down. Okay. Advise the client to maintain log of the date, time, activity preceding shock, symptoms preceding shocks and post-shock sensation. So this everything he should be log of. So that means he should be note out what is the date, time and activities, what he has done and post shock sensation and all this, everything you should note down. Instruct the client and family in how to assess the emergency medical system. So we need to inform the instruct the client and family also how to assess the emergency medical system. Encourage the family to learn CPR. So we need to teach the CPR, how much compression, how to give compression and all, and rescue and breathing. Okay, mouth to mouth breathe by ambu bag if it is available. So this everything we need to teach in CPR to the family. Instruct the client to avoid electromagnetic field. This is very important when implanted pacemaker is there, sorry, implanted cardioversion is there. So he should not come into the directly electromagnetic field. Okay, so he should avoid this electromagnetic field directly over the AICD, because they can inactive the device. So it can inactive the device and it will not work. Then instruct the client to move away from the magnetic field. So we need to instruct the client, he should not go to the magnetic field immediately if beeping tones are heard, to the notify the SCP. So if beeping tones are heard, so he should inform the SCP. So instruct the client move away from the magnetic field. He should not go on the electromagnetic field or magnetic field. Keep an AICD identification card. So he should have a AICD identification card. Wear a medic alert bracelet. So in hand, medic alert bracelet should be there. Inform all SCP that AICD has been inserted. So we need to inform the all SCPs where AICD has inserted, and certain diagnostic tests such as MRI and procedure using diathermy or electrocardiography interfere the AICD functions. So we should inform the all the SCPs, and AICD is there. So if we are using the MI, patient is going for MI, so patient should not go MI because AICD is there, and this diathermy and all we are using, so it will affect on the AICD function, it will not work the properly. Now coming to pacemaker. So how pacemaker works? So pacemaker, there are two types of pacemaker. One is temporary, one is permanent device. That will provide the electrical stimulation and maintain the heart rate when the client's intrinsic pacemaker fails and provide the perfusion rhythm. So pacemaker, when we are using, actually natural pacemaker is SA node. So SA node only initiate the electrical activity. When it is not working properly, then we provide the external pacemaker means artificial pacemaker. That will be temporary, we can put, and permanent. So it will maintain the sinus rhythm. So how it will work? There will be a synchronous and asynchronous. Though two types we read, that will be things will be there, synchronous or asynchronous. So synchronous means demand pacemaker senses the client's rhythm and paces only if the client's intrinsic rate falls below the set pacemaker rate for stimulating the depolarization. So this is demand. So that means we need like 90 beats per minute, but it is going below the 60. So then this will work and it will increase the heart rate. Asynchronous means pacemaker paces preset regulates the client's intrinsic rhythm and use the client is systolic and profoundly bradycardia. So whenever patient is going in bradycardia, it will work and it will initiate the sinus rhythm. Okay, so there will be two types, synchronized, that is demand, how much demand is. So it should keep on the demanding, like this much 80 beats per minute we need. So at that, whenever it is going below the 80, so it will work. And asynchronous means, so whenever it is going on bradycardia, so it will work. Okay, so there are two types. Overdrive pacing suppress the underlying rhythm and take care dysarrhythmia, so that sinus node will regain the control of heart. Spike. So spike, what is spike? So this is also important here. Spike, when pacing stimulus is delivered to the heart, spikes a straight vertical line is seen on the monitor ECG strip. So when this pacemaker is working, so there will be, you can see on the ECG, there will be a vertical line. okay, there will be a straight vertical line. A spike precedes chambers being pressed, a spike preceding a P wave indicate that the atrium is pressed. Whenever atrium is pressed, so P wave will be indicated, okay, like a straight line will be there on P wave. So that means spikes on the P wave. A spike preceding the QRS complex indicate the ventricle is being pressed. So when atrium is pressed, atrium is being pressed, that means on P wave ventricular line will be there. When vertical line will be there. When ventricles are being pressed on QRS complex, that time itself, what will be there? Vertical line will be there, or spike will be there. An atrial spike followed by P wave indicator of atrial defibrillation. So it will denote the atrial defibrillation. And ventricular spike will follow the QRS complexes, that will be ventricular depolarization. So when on P wave vertical line or P wave is there, so it spike is there, it will say that is atrial depolarization. When at the time of QRS complex spike is there, that will tell ventricular depolarization is there. Okay, now coming to temporary pacemaker. So what is temporary pacemaker? So it is non-invasive transcutaneous pacing. So in this, what we do, non-invasive transcutaneous pacing is used to temporary emergency. So whenever temporary emergency is there, so it will used. And in the profoundly bradycardia or systolic client is until invasive pacing can be initiated. So it is temporary we use. So in temporary, in this, what we use, so whenever bradycardia is there or systolic condition is there, so temporary non-invasive transcutaneous pacing will be used until invasive pacing can be initiated. Okay, large electrode pads are placed on the client's chest and back and connected to the external pulse generator. So it will be, electrode will be kept on the chest and back, and it will be connected to the external pulse generator. Wash the skin with the soap water before the applying electrodes. So we should wash and put the soap before applying the electrodes. If it is not necessary, should shave the hair or apply alcohol tincture to the skin. So it is not necessary to apply alcohol and all and shaving the skin, just wash with the soap and water itself. Place the posterior electrode between the spine. So posterior electrode where we need to keep. So posterior between the spine and left scapula. So between the spine, like this is spine and this is scapula. So between this we need to keep the posterior electrode and place the anterior electrode. So anterior electrode where we need to keep, between to V2 and V5. Like this is V1, V2, V3, V4 and V5 here. So in between that, here we can keep the electrode. So place the anterior electrode between the V2, V5 positions over the heart, and posterior is where we need to keep, between the spine and left scapula. So understood? One more time we'll see. Posterior electrode where? Between the spine and left scapula, and anterior electrode between the V2 and V5 position of the over the heart. And do not place the anterior electrode over the female breast. So again this come. So we no need to keep the, it should be avoided. So female breast, we should not keep the electrode directly. Okay, rather displace the breast tissues and place the electrode under the breast. So we need to displace the breast tissue, and under the breast we can keep the electrode. So never keep the electrode on the female breast tissues. Do not take the pulse or BP on the left side. So we no need to take the left side BP. So always avoid the BP taking on the left side when pacemaker or cardioversion or these things are happening. And the result will not be accurate because the muscle twitching and electrical current is there. So whenever current is passing, so result will not be accurate when we are taking pulse or BP. Ensure the electrodes are in good contact with the skin. So we need to ensure the electrodes are with good contact with the skin. If it is not good contact, so false activity will be delivered. And set pacing rate as prescribed. Establish stimulation and threshold to ensure capture. So pacing rate we need to set whatever is prescribed. इफ लॉस ऑफ कैप्चर अकर्स असेस द स्किन कॉन्टैक्ट ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रोड्स एंड इंक्रीज द करंट अंटिल कैप्चर इज रीगेंड. ओके सो इफ इट इज लॉस सो अगेन वी नीड टू इंक्रीज द करंट सो अंटिल कैप्चर इज रीगेंड. एवेल्यूएट द क्लाइंट फॉर डिस्कम्फर्ट फ्रॉम द क्यूटेनियस एंड मसल स्टिमुलेशन सो वी नीड टू इंश्योर द क्लाइंट डिस्कम्फर्ट. ओके एडमिनिस्टर एनाल्जेसिक इफ इट इज नीडेड. ओके इनवेसिव ट्रांस वीनस पेसिंग. नाउ इनवेसिव ट्रांस पेसिंग वीनस पेसिंग व्हाट वी नीड टू डू पेसिंग अ लेड वायर इन द प्लेस थ्रू द एंटी क्यूबिटल फीमोरल जुगलर एंड सबक्लेवियन वीन टू द राइट एट्रियम. ओके सो वेन एवर वी आर गोइंग टू पुट एनीथिंग इन द राइट साइड ऑफ द हर्ट वी यूज द वीन. वी यूज द वीन लाइक राइट साइड कैथेटराइजेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डू सो वी ऑलवेज यूज द वीन लाइक फीमोरल एंटीक्यूबिटल जुगलर एंड सबक्लेवियन बिकॉज इट विल डायरेक्टली गो टू द एट्रियम. ओके एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डू ऑफ द लेफ्ट साइड देन वी यूज द एट्री बाय एरोटा वी गो और एनी अदर आर्टरी वी यूज. ओके मॉनिटर द पेस मेकर इंसर्शन साइट रिस्ट्रिक्ट द क्लाइंट मूवमेंट टू प्रिवेंट लीड वायर displacement. So we should restrict the client movement because it will prevent to the lead wire displacement. So we should prevent the lead wire displacement. Invasive epicardial pacing apply by using a transthoracic approach. The lead wire are threaded loosely on the epicardial surface of the heart after cardiac surgery. So applied by using a transthoracic approach. So invasive epicardial pacing will be there. How we use it is transthoracic approach. So by thoracically we can do the lead wire are threaded loosely on the epicardial surface. So it will be threaded loosely where on the epicardial surface of the heart. So after the cardiac surgery, reducing the risk of microshock. So we need to reduce the risk for microshock. How? Use only inspected and approved equipments. So inspected approved equipment only we need to use. Insulated the exposed portion of wires with the plastic and rubber materials, finger of rubber gloves when wires are not attached to the pulse generator and cover with the non-conductive tape. So what it is saying, insulate the exposed portion of wire. So we need to insulate the exposed portion of wire with the plastic or rubber material. So we need to insulate the, how we can do with the plastic or rubber material is there. So we can put on the wires, whatever exposed wire is there, and fingers of the rubber gloves. When wires are not attached to the pulse generator, cover with non-conductive tape. If it is not covered with, not connected with to generator, and we need to cover with the non-conductive tape. So we can cover it with the non-conductive tape also. Ground all electrical equipment using a three-pronged plug. So we need three-pronged plug. Wearing gloves when handling exposed wires. So when we are handling the exposed wire, we need to wear the gloves and keep dry the dressing. So we need to keep the dry dressing. So here important point is there, vital signs are monitored and cardiac monitoring is done continuously for the client with the pacemaker. So whenever pacemaker is there, so we need to monitor the vital signs and cardiac monitoring. Now coming to permanent, that was the temporary. Now permanent pacemaker. So pulse generator is internal and surgically implanted in subcutaneous pocket below the clavicle. So below the clavicle it will be surgically implanted. Okay. The leads are passed intravenously via cephalic subclavian vein to the endocardium of the right side of the heart, and postoperatively limitation of arm movement on operative side is required to prevent the lead wires dislodgement. So it will be passed transvenously via cephalic or subclavian vein we can use and to the endocardium of the right side of the heart, and postoperatively we need to limit the arm of movement of the patients. Okay, and post operative on the operative side is required to prevent lead wire is dislodgement. So we need to restrict the movement. We should ask the client, no need, it should not be have activity of the left arm. Permanent pacemaker may be सिंगल चैम्बर्ड इन विच द लेवल लेड वायर इज प्लेस्ड इन द चैम्बर टू बी प्लेस्ड, और डुअल चैम्बर्ड विद लेड वायर प्लेस्ड इन द बोथ राइट एट्रियम एंड राइट वेंट्रिकल्स. सो देर कैन बी अ परमानेंट पेसमेकर मे बी सिंगल चैम्बर्ड और डबल चैम्बर्ड. ओके, सो इफ सिंगल चैम्बर्ड इज देयर इट कैन बी प्लेस्ड इन द राइट एट्रियम, और बोथ डुअल चैम्बर्ड इज देयर सो इट विल बी प्लेस्ड इन द राइट एट्रियम एंड राइट वेंट्रिकल्स. ओके, सो दैट इज परमानेंट पेसमेकर. सो हाउ व्हाट आर द अदर थिंग्स वी नीड टू, व्हाई वेंट्रिकुलर पेसिंग ऑफ द वेंट्रिकल्स अलोस फॉर द सिंक्रोनाइज्ड, 1 मिनट, दिस इज फिनिश्ड. ओके, दिस इज द व्हाई वेंट्रिकुलर पेसिंग ऑफ वेंट्रिकल allows the for synchronized depolarization and is used for moderate to severe heart failure to improve cardiac output. So why ventricular pacing? When we use, whenever severe heart failure is there, so for that we need to provide the synchronized depolarization. Heart failure is there, so if heart failure is there, so cardiac output will be decreased. So for the increasing the cardiac output, we use why ventricular pacing. A permanent pacemaker is programmed when inserted and can be programmed if necessary by non-invasive transmission from an external programmer or to the implanted generator. So permanent pacemaker is programmed when inserted and can be reprogrammed if necessary by non-invasive transmission. So it can be reprogrammed if necessary by non-invasive transmission from the external programmer to the implanted generator. Okay, it can be reprogrammed if it is necessary. Pacemaker may be powered by lithium battery. So this is very important point here, very very important. So pacemaker may be powered by which battery? Lithium battery. Or average life span of type 10 years. So its average life span is 10 years. Nuclear powered by life span of 20 years. So nuclear powered life span is 20 years and lithium battery life span is 20 years. Okay, or longer, or designed to the to be recharged externally. So it can be recharged externally. Okay, which one? Nuclear powered, whereas lithium it will be only for 10 years. Pacemaker function can be checked in the SCP's office or clinic by pacemaker interrogator or programmer, or from home using a special telephonic transmitter. So what we do when pacemaker is inserted, it will be connected to the telephonic transmitter device. So it will give the whatever data is there, it will be provided to the SCP's office or clinic. Okay, the client may be provided by device placed over a pacemaker battery generator with an attachment to the telephone, the heart rate then the can be transferred to the clinic. Same only it has written. So whatever pacemaker is there and it will be provided device over the pacemaker battery generator with an attachment of the telephone. So it will be attached to the telephone. So it will give the whatever heart rate and rhythm, it will be transmitted to the clinic. Okay, who has transplanted this monitors. Now coming to pacemaker client education. So what we need to instruct the client. So instruct the client about the pacemaker including the program rate. So important point is instruct the client signs symptoms of battery failure. If battery failure is there, he should inform the SCP when notify the SCP. Okay, instruct the client report fever, redness, swelling and drainage from insertion sign. Then he need to inform the SCP. Report the sign of dizziness, weakness, fatigue, swelling, ankles or legs, chest pain and shortness of breath is there. Then he need to inform. Keep pacemaker identification card wallet. So he should keep the identification card if pacemaker is there. That is medical alert bracelet will be there, he should wear that. Instruct the client how to make pulse, to take the pulse daily and maintain diary of pulse. So how to maintain a diary of pulse and how to take a pulse, so that we should do. wear loose fitting clothes over the pulse generator side. Avoid contact sports. Okay, these everything. Instruct the client, inform airport security. Okay, when pacemaker is there, advise the client not to operate the electrical appliances. Transmitter towers, avoid the transmitter towers and anti-theft devices in the store. Instruct the client if any unusual feelings occurs when near any electrical devices to move 5 to 10 feet away to check the pulse. Okay. Instruct the client most electrical appliances can be used without any interference with the functioning of the pacemaker. So most of the thing can be used, but advise the client not to operate electrical appliances directly over the pacemaker site. Use cell phone on the side opposite to the pacemaker. Okay, and we need to tell the client follow up should be done. Okay, these are the management of this arrhythmias we have seen in this video. So I hope you would have liked this video. Tomorrow we will start the next video, we will start coronary artery disease. So thank you all of you. Please subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed, and share these videos to others also. So let others also get benefited by this video. And please subscribe, like my video and share it. Thank you all of you. We'll meet in next video. Thank you.